Foreigners who pump money into our economy may soon be at the front of the queue to gain entry into New Zealand. The indication from the Prime Minister came at a high-powered forum in Auckland, where the conversation was all about the pandemic recovery. Katie Branford was there.
New Zealand's beauty and COVID-free status are the envy of the world. Now many want us open for business.
New Zealand can be a real hub for the Asia Pacific, and we should be really brave about that.
Our economy's booming now, but as other countries vaccinate their populations, we'll face a race for talent and opportunities. Rapidly growing tech companies like Soul Machines say we need to do more to compete.
We're not going to have the opportunity to stop and think and wait and take our time over these decisions.
The government's been under pressure over immigration, and the minister will reveal details of new criteria next week, but his boss got in ahead with some hints today.
Changes to attract targeted, high-value international investment into New Zealand, something many in this room have been calling for. Because even while our borders are restricted, we need to stay open for business growth and development.
It's hugely important. The investment is into business is what creates high-quality jobs. I think particularly foreign direct investment, we are bringing expertise with that investment.
The Prime Minister and business leaders also pushing the get vaccinated message, saying if we want to boost our economy, open the borders and give businesses certainty, everyone who can get vaccinated needs to do so. And with that comes more pleas to allow more people in sooner.
Those are people who want to do business here but don't want to spend 2 weeks in quarantine.
I couldn't put numbers around it, but I do, you know, in the conversations that I have, there are a number of people who say, how can we come to New Zealand?
The Prime Minister's opening the door to allowing in visitors who've been vaccinated quarantine free.
It will, however, be contingent on data, evidence, the view of experts.
This top scientist says low ambitions holding Auckland back, and we need to think creatively, turning West Auckland into a Kiwi Hollywood, for example.
And what I would like to do is see Auckland look ahead, but there are some big decisions needed to be made if Auckland is to actually move ahead rapidly.
One of the biggest gripes, a lack of a firm economic plan.
And there's a huge amount of ambiguity around this.
The message here: draw a line under the crisis and think bravely about the future. Katie Bradford, One News.